Welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm Betsy McDaniel. Sandy Benson is off today. And joining me is Robin Swift, the Vice President of Marketing and Development for Coastal Discovery Museum at Honeyhorn, and also artist Steve Mardell. Did I get that right? I did. I stuttered, but I got it right. And we're going to be talking about the art market today. So welcome, guys. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
So it is art market time.
Yes, it is.
How many years has this been going on?
18.
18. That's a long time, but it's a great event.
It is.
I'm sure it gets bigger and better every year.
It does.
Yeah. So Steve, as an artist, tell us what makes you want to participate in this particular event.
Well, it's a juried art show, which means that they're taking care as to making sure that it's a good quality, very diverse artist selection.
Okay.
It's really nice. It's the nicest time of year, really, to be here.
Hilton had such a beautiful location.
Honeyhorn is such a beautiful location. So if you haven't been there, it's just a good excuse to go spend the day there. So
yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. And obviously we have some jewelry.
You're a
jewelry artist, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But what other kind of artists do we expect to see there?
Oh, we have everything. We've got sculptors. We've got oil acrylics. We have fabric artists. You name it. We have wood turners. I mean, we have just about everything. We try really hard to get a nice variety when we jury people in. So it's always fun to see what's new and different.
Yeah. And I think I read it was something more like 90 plus artists that are there.
Yes. So, and we have 15 states being represented this year.
Wow. Yeah. That's exciting. Is that the most ever?
It used to always be 12 states. So now it's 15, which is great.
Yeah.
So, you know, a lot of people get on this circuit and they've heard about the show because other artists talk about the show. So we're excited about that.
Yeah. And is there anything new this year that we can expect?
Well, what's kind of fun is the Herb Society is going to be there. They've always had different locations, and so they're going to be there on Saturday, 10 o'clock, with their herb sale, which is just kind of fun. They make horseradish jelly, pepper jellies.
Okay, that is the best thing ever.
Yes.
If you have not had the horseradish, that sounds weird, but
it's really good.
It is. It's really good.
So they're going to partner with us and be there Saturday from the time we open until they sell out, which is pretty early. So we think that'll be a nice mix to have there.
Yeah, yeah. So tell us, Steve, about your art and what you're going to be showing at the show.
I'm a glass bead maker. The technique is called lamp working, so it refers to working the glass over an oil-fueled lamp, whereas today it's a gas-fueled torch. So it's an old term, but it is considered lamp working.
Okay.
Glass, and I work some fine silver into all these pieces as well, just creating that organic effect. I'm obviously inspired by the area. Really, as the tide pools sort of meander through the sand, that's what I see as I make these pieces.
Yeah.
So.
And that's exactly what it looks like, and they're really beautiful. But you incorporate some pearls and some different things.
And girls have to have their pearls.
Girls have to have their pearls.
This is one from last year that I bought, and we've got to have our pearls.
It's gorgeous. So you do, even this is all kind of in the blues, but that's a little bit different. So there's a variety, and obviously you have things that men can wear as well, because you are sporting one too.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, excellent. And so, what, is there an admission fee?
$3 per person. Okay. We used to do it per car and everything, and we said, no, let's just do per person. You know, we want people to get in and see the artist and have just a great experience.
Yeah.
So it's,
And is it run? I'm sorry, I know you said the Herb Society is there Saturday,
right,
but it runs the whole weekend?
Yes. It's April 28th and 29th, and we're from 10 to 5 on the Saturday, and then 11 to 4 on the Sunday.
Tell us a little bit about the process of choosing the artists.
Oh, this is a tremendous process. Like Steve said, we jury people in, and one of the other gals and some people assist her in doing that, because we don't want to buy and sell type of show, which happens at a lot of places where somebody goes and buys a bunch of these things and brings them in. It has to be original work. The artist has to be in the booth with their original work. They can't say, oh, this is my friend's, that kind of thing. So we go through juring, and then we have a judge at the show. Not only are they there to sell their works, but we give away prize money. And so we have a judge. It's Michael Haga this year from College of Charleston, and he will be there judging on Saturday morning.
Okay.
So he goes booth to booth looking at different things, then most of them come back a second time and go booth to booth. I think you won an award a couple of years ago, too. So it's, you know, it's monetary, which helps as well, plus the ribbons on their booth, so everybody knows they
everybody
were a winner.
Everybody knows.
Right.
Everybody, so what was the award that you won previously?
Award of Merit.
Okay. Well, these are gorgeous, and it sounds like a great event.
Yeah.
So make sure you're getting to Honeyhorn on April 28th and 29th for the art show, the juried art show, and the Herb Society's horseradish jelly, because you got to try it. And we'll be right back on Talk of the Town.